talking about Marty Perk, who just took that hit. He took some hits in the pregame, too, from his own teammates. Here's why. White helmet there. I don't know why. He's got the red helmet coming out. You can see Trevor Daly laughing on the way out. Marty Ferk went for some time. Bernier having a laugh. I know he took a while before he finally realized.
He was focused. He was dialed in and he was focused. He's not colorblind. They're all having it.
Across the line, Dahlin. Back for Madonna. Oh, was he hit? Messier looked like he hit him in the head with the shoulder.
And as the pass comes across, Mark Messier coming from behind and shoulder right into the head of Mike Modano. Modano being taken in an ambulance.
He is conscious. Yeah. You can see the eyes open. Oh, look at that. Oh, my goodness. Oh. I can't believe we just saw that. They dropped. That was live in the tunnel. They just dropped the stretcher. Oh, my goodness.
First change of the day.
That's the first thing today.
This is bizarre. During the celebration, fans in Boston knock one of the panels of glass loose. It tumbles onto the ice, hitting David Krejci in the head. He went down in a heap. So bizarre end. But the Bruins do win game one.
In his knee, recovering from that. The stick is in the back of Mrazek. He's carrying a stick all the way down the ice with him. Now that's having two sticks on you, but not in your hand. That's caught up. Is it caught up in the tie, in the tie down?
Yeah, it looks like that's what's happened. You think you've seen everything, but...
What have you scored with that, Murph? Is that playing with an illegal stick?
It goes off that stick he's dragging behind. That would definitely be a first.
Terrified spectators go tumbling off a malfunctioning escalator. The chaos erupted at a Philadelphia Flyers hockey game. Video shows fans piling one into another at the bottom of the escalator, which for some reason had sped up without warning.
We are experiencing a delay, and I can safely say this is a National Hockey League first, I believe. S.J. Sharkey, the Sharks' popular mascot, in an effort to try and bungee from the ceiling of the arena during the pregame introductions, got stuck. He has been stuck for about 5 minutes now, can't get down. They are putting rubber mats under him, and they're going to make some sort of an effort here to try and get him down to the ice or pull him back up. Hey, that's showbiz. Yeah. All right. We're ready.
That's plenty of excitement for a full game.
February 2008, start of a Sharks-Penguins game, delayed 25 minutes after Zamboni left red hydraulic fluid. It looks like blood.
Are they putting up plywood?
I don't know.
There's going to be some unhappy fans.
Hurricane season's over.
Where did they get it with this? They don't have extra glass?
They have no choice.
Where are they going to move the fans?
Yeah, the fellas continue to work here at the BB&T Center.
I think it all began back in 1975 when the Flyers were playing Buffalo in the Stanley Cup playoffs, and a bat started dive-bombing the players. Well, one of the guys smacked it and killed it, and then the Flyers' Rick McLeish picked it up and dumped it. And that may have been the start of the Phantom Fog Curse, because later in the game, fog started coming out of nowhere inside the arena, and you couldn't see the puck. But did they cancel the game? No! They kept on playing, and the Flyers lost.
It's off of his stick, and Prosser has to hustle back to break up what would have been a scoring chance for Watson the other way. Watson plays across. Wilson into the Minnesota zone. Stumbled for a moment, and Minnesota has it.
He lost the blade on his... Yeah, he lost the entire bottom part of his skate. There's not even any... anything left. Usually the blade will fall out. The entire skate fell off. You watch as he's digs into the ice, and there it goes. every so often, as I mentioned, you'll see just the steel fall.
So 1-0, Dallas in the lead. Andy Niemi came out in the warm-up tonight with his sweater, and he was wearing the sweater that you see on the left. And we got a phone call. Mrs. Niemi, his mom called. He said, you spelled his name wrong. Well, we didn't do it, but they did. Somehow it got all mixed up in the dressing room, and now it's Niemi.
All of a sudden, looked down, and I thought, what is that on the ice?
Now we've got something thrown out on the ice. Puck is picked up and cleared to center. Something out on the ice. It's a chicken. Somebody threw a live chicken on the ice. Play is continuing.
And the curious thing to me was, the game continued for several seconds with players skating around the chicken, and I thought, well, when are they going to stop this game?
Taken by Naslund. He sends it in, just missed hitting the chicken, and finally, play stops.